Take a breath. Take a breath in and breathe out. You are peace. You are joy. You are love. You are what you are looking for. Once again, become aware of our feelings. Become aware of your thoughts. Become aware of your body. Become aware of your surroundings. Take a deep breath in. And breathe out, taking your own time. When you feel like, you may open your eyes. How was it? We had a very short version today because of the time constraints. Great, no? There's a very famous saying of Gandhiji. He used to meditate every day while he carried the moment. He said he used to meditate for 1 hour daily. Then he said, I'm very busy today. I can't meditate for 1 hour. So people said then, so I'll have to meditate for 2 hours today because I'm very, very busy today. So, you know, meditation is so, so powerful. It makes us stronger at the level of body and mind both. So in these times of distress, I think it is the greatest gift we can give to our mind is to take out 10-15 minutes every day just for our mental hygiene. Those dental hygiene karte hai na, we brush our teeth daily, we clean our home, we do jhadu poncha in our home every day. But what do we do to clean all the kachra here? How do we empty the trash that is accumulated in the mind? Meditation is one of the most effective ways. You know, we watch a movie, we listen to some songs, we forget it for some minutes, some hours. But the problem does not get solved. But when we meditate, it changes the wiring of our brain and we're able to solve the problem better. I'm not against movies, I also love watching them. Please do that. But apart from that, you know, taking out 10 minutes just to meditate and declutter and detox the mind is very, very essential in today's times. It's not a luxury anymore. It has become mandatory in today's times. So I can share the link with sir if you all would like to do it. You can just every day before work or after work take out some time to relax. Yeah. And I would like to end my session with a very beautiful story which helps me to sail through life. So you want to know? It's very interesting. I really love that. How many of you would like to know? Okay. So Gurudev Sri Sri Ravi Shankar ji says the measure of your success is through the smile on your face. So it's not through what you have accumulated or what you possess, but the smile and the confidence that you exude. So there's a story of a guy called Mullah Nasruddin. So aap logon ne suna hoga, unke bahut famous stories hoti hain. So one day Mullah Nasruddin, he was a farmer and he was sitting outside his home and he was very upset. He was holding his head and he was just sitting like this, very, very stressed. His friend was passing by and his friend stopped and said, Mullah, what happened? You're very stressed. He said, I'm a farmer. How can I be happy? It has not rained. Barish hi nahi hui hai. I don't have my crops. Nothing is there. How can I be happy? Of course, I'm stressed. His friend said, correct, yaar. So true. How can you be happy? You're a farmer. Tumhara rozi roti banta hai. He said, okay, I'm so sorry. Then his friend went away. And his friend came back once again after 5 months. In these 5 months, it had rained really well. Really, it was a good time for the farmers, for the harvesting people. So his friend came back after 5 months expecting his friend to be very happy. And he again saw Mullah and Mullah was sitting like this outside his home. His friend said, what happened? Why are you upset now? It rained so well. All the crops have come. Why are you upset? He said, what are you saying? It rained so well and all the crops have come. I have so much work to do. I don't have time for anything else. From morning to night, I'm just working, working, working. How can I be happy? So we all live our life like Mullah Nasruddin. Naukri nahi hai. Naukri hai. Arre, kuch aur karne ka time nahi hai. I don't have money. Oh my God. I have money. Oh my God. It should stay with me. It should grow more. We find reasons to be unhappy. We just find reasons. How can I be stressed and, you know, not relaxed? It's so important just to let go and be happy. Living our life with a sense of happiness. Once I was invited for a talk by, it was an IIT BHU and I had to address 60 IIT professors from across the country. And I was 21 years old at that time. I was so stressed. I was so, so stressed. And how am I going to address 60 professors who are like almost double my age on happiness and on, you know, mind management? I was so scared. And I entered the hall and all of them were like very, very well qualified, like, you know, double PhD holders and some deans of some IIT, some HODs. And I just went in there and they made my job very easy. I saw all faces like this. would not see one face happy. I would not see one face relaxed. And I said, that's it. So easy. You know, and they were so amused to see a 21-year-old talking so confidently in front of 50-plus-year-old people. We achieve so much in so many levels, but that satisfaction does not come. That contentment only does not come. And time will come for us to just say bye-bye to the planet. It is just coming for people at any age. 40-year-old TV actors are going away because of heart attacks. Anything is happening. Life is so fragile. And we keep on postponing our happiness. Just be happy. Be happy right now. Okay, it is COVID. This is how it is. Let's see what can we do now. Okay, COVID is over. Very good. Let's go back to college. Let's see what we can do now. Having the ability to be with time, having the ability to smile in life is a gift that meditation gives us. So I would really, really encourage all of you to take out time for this, for some breathing technique, for some meditation on a day-to-day basis. Apart from that, to manage your mind better, good food, good sleep, and exercise. Definitely take out time either for your walking, yoga, dance, any sort of exercise that keeps us younger at the level of the brain. The brain feels younger when we exercise. It grows older very fast for those who do not use their body much. Yeah, thank you so much. It was so nice being with you all. I hope you all enjoyed. Are there any questions?
Yeah, thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Really a very informative and a good session, ma'am.
Thank you so much.
So now it is open to all of you. Kindly, if you have any queries, please ask.
I'll share it with you. You can take it. Thank you. I'll share some techniques also with him, which you can practice every day, which will really help you.
Thank you, ma'am, for this wonderful session, for guiding us. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
So,
I think there are no questions. Sure, Rupali ji, I'll do that. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. So, if we have anything, we can take it up. Else, we can.
Okay, thank you. Sapnesi, kindly announce the participant will join again.
We'll keep it. Yes, children should be encouraged to do yoga. It is very important. It surprisingly, it makes them a better student. Yeah, yoga makes one a better student. So definitely encourage children to do it.
Thank you, madam. So next session is the technical session, and it will start from 12 o'clock.
Thank
so
you,
all
everyone.
Participants join at 12 o'clock. Sharply, thank you for this attending.
Yeah, ma'am, once again, thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. It's my honor to be with all of you.
Definitely, in future also, we'll connect you, ma'am, and we'll take some sessions.
Definitely. Okay. Bye bye.
Bye, ma'am. All of you can mark your attendance.